welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new here. Today we're going ahead and doing a challenge video. Now this is a build challenge, but I'm presenting it in speed build form because if I had done this real time with you guys, it would have taken over an hour and a half, if not 2 hours, because I would have been like talking as well. And also I just feel like I would not have been capable of talking whilst doing this because it was so challenging. Now I have seen a couple other simmers do this, so I'm going to go ahead and link their videos down below because I've seen some other people do it and that's where I got the inspiration from. So this challenge, the basic premise is you need to go ahead and write up a list of everything you would usually do in building a house. So think about what are things you do, what are things you add, what order do you usually do things in. And then you need to go ahead and click on that list and make it in alphabetical order. Now, I think this idea sort of stems from James Charles's ABC makeup challenge. I feel like that was a thing just a couple weeks before this became a thing in the Sims world. So yeah, basically you just need to do what you normally do, but you can only do it in alphabetical order. So what I did was I came up with a list on my phone of everything I would do in this house that I was envisioning in my head. So I'm going to set the picture first because it will not be clear to you guys at all in this build what my idea was. And I don't even think it'll be clear like once we start putting the walls in or anything like that. It just doesn't end up looking like anything like what I wanted it to look like. So in my head, I was imagining a nice like country beachside house, a nice rural old school house. It was going to be set up for just a single sim to live in. It would be one bedroom, it would have one bathroom, open plan, kitchen, living, dining, and a nice backyard that was suited for entertaining and like a pool and maybe some like kids playground equipment left by previous owners, or maybe she has like kids that she babysits or like nieces or nephews that come and visit a lot. So I just wanted to create a really beautiful, rustic looking house that had been renovated by this like young girl, I was imagining. So basically this young girl bought this house. Maybe it was owned by like her grandparents or an elderly couple in the past. She went ahead and bought it and she's putting her own touches on it, modernizing like the bathroom, putting her own furniture in it and just giving the walls a lick of paint. But other than that, I wanted it to be quite classic within a lot of aspects. Like maybe she knocked down a wall or two, she's done a couple of things here and there, but overall I wanted it to look very like beach holiday house. I don't know, but you will not get those vibes at all from this house because of just how it turned out. So here is my usual list. I would usually start this build and most builds, but like the build I had in mind, with doing the porch. I would usually start off using like the rectangle or square like porch piece, the foundation piece, and I'll make it the size I want and then raise the foundation up. And then from there, I would do the walls. So I'd do the exterior walls, like the shape of the house from the outside. And then I would do the floor plan, like with the wall tool. Then I would go ahead and paint the floors. Then I would paint the walls. So that's always something I do. I do the walls of the exterior. I map out the floor plan. Then I go ahead and pick what is going to be the bathroom and put tiles or whatever in there. Go ahead and map out what's going to be the bedrooms, put carpet in there, and the living spaces, do floorboards or whatever it is, I'll do it then and do the exterior. So with this one, I'll do like shingle looking things and or like sliding, masonry, whatever. That's when I would do that. Then I'll go ahead and add any stairs. So if I'm putting the house up on foundation, I would go ahead and put stairs at the porch and the back porch. Or if it's a two-story house, that's when I put the stairs up to the second story, stuff like that. Then once I have the floor plan, the stairs, everything mapped out, I'll go ahead and add the windows because I don't like to add the windows before the stairs and whatnot in case you decide like, oh, that's going to be where the stairs are, now the window's blocked. Or if you decide, oh, that room's going to be the bathroom, you'd put a different window in there than what you would have if you didn't know what that room was originally. Like you might put a big, huge window there and it does make a lot of sense because it's a bathroom and it's like facing the neighbors, so it's kind of awkward. Anyway, then I would do the windows and then the doors. So add in the windows, make sure everything looks nice and light and bright, and then I go ahead and add the doors. But as you can see, I'm adding the doors right now before I have even done the walls. And this does work. If you use move objects and then move objects the walls, it will keep the doors there, which is pretty cool. I didn't realize that would be a thing, but it does. I actually haven't play tested this, so it could just not work at all. I got sick of this build in the end. pretty much from the start, I was like, damn it, I had this really cool idea and now I'm not really going to be able to execute it because you just have no idea how much room stuff is going to take up. Like, and also the scaling and like the, like one tile in The Sims is so different to what it would be in real life. So it's really hard to judge and gauge what's going on. But yeah. Okay, so then next I would do the backyard. Just like finish the landscaping in the backyard. I don't know. A lot of people leave the backyard to last and I probably do a lot of the time. But I just had a lot of ideas for the backyard of this house because I did want that pool out because like they got the beach, but they've also got the pool for when it's cooler or like not good weather and like they can entertain. And then I would have done the fences. So the fences on the porches and leading around the outskirts of the property and stuff like that around the pool. Then I would do columns, roof, landscaping. So landscaping aside from the backyard. So the backyard means more the entertaining area and then you add the landscaping in afterwards. Then I do lighting. So I go, once I'm done outside, I hop inside. I'll grab my sub tool sources, as I like to call them, and I'll size them down and place them into rooms to make sure it's nice and light and bright in nighttime mode. Then I'll go ahead and furnish in this order. Kitchen, dining, living room, bedroom, bathroom, laundry. So I decided I wanted to put a laundry in this house to challenge myself, and it was interesting because I absolutely forgot to make room for it when I was doing everything else, and then by the time I got to laundry, I didn't have a room for it, so it's like sort of just tacked in there, so that's kind of funny. But anyway, here's the ABC order that we've already got stuck into. So we had to start with the backyard, which was horrible. Oh, it was so bad. I started on a different lot and I had to change to a smaller lot because having a big lot, when you're just placing things aimlessly around without knowing where anything else is, it is so painful. Like, you just don't know where it's going to be. And I'm so glad I switched to a slightly smaller lot because the other one was huge and it was just going to look ridiculous. So then I had to do the bathroom, then the bedroom, and then the columns. So you'll see in this build, I definitely missed some columns. Like, there are places where columns are needed for structural reasons. Like, the roof is going to fall down because there's no columns in certain areas. And also just looks stupid. Like, I have the fences stopping to let stairs go up, but I didn't put columns near where the stairs go. So I couldn't add them afterwards though, because I'd already done the column step. So if I had done foundation and stairs and whatnot in my usual order, then I probably would have realized, but I didn't. Anyway, then we do the dining room, the doors, which I feel like is the stupidest thing because you have no walls, but the doors is probably the thing that worked out the best, if I'm being honest. Then you have to go ahead and do the fences, flooring, kitchen, and landscaping. So fences, it's okay. Flooring actually helped a lot. Like, it helped me map out the floor plan better. But once again, because I hadn't done the floor plan for each room, adding in the floorboards made it really hard because I forgot the laundry that I'm now adding in, which I think is actually cute where it is. Like, it's fine, but I wouldn't normally have put it there. I would have made it its own room. Then what did I get up to? Kitchen and then landscaping. So yeah, landscaping was probably an okay part because at that point I had the flooring. I sort of knew where the house was going to be so I could do the landscaping, but I hadn't done the roof yet, which is usually what I do before I add landscaping because I like to know if the trees are going to be like intercepting with the roof. So I tried to just place some kind of far away-ish from the house. So then after the landscaping, I had to do the laundry, which you guys just saw, then the lighting. So right now I'm adding in the lighting. And it is so weird because the house is technically outside. The lighting looks stupid. It looks ridiculous. So I'm just adding in like way too much lighting because it's so dark. But then when you add the walls, it's way too bright in some areas. So it's a little bit of a mess there because obviously The Sims 4 has some funky lighting for inside and outside and like artificial lighting and the natural outdoor lighting. So it really just clashed in this challenge because we didn't have walls where we would normally have walls. So that was kind of weird. Then we do the living room, which I forgot. I forgot to do the living room, and right now I'm doing the porch. Before porch, it should be like wall painting, like painting the walls. But I couldn't paint the walls before the walls were there. So I just included, like I got rid of that and just said, when I place the walls, I'll also paint the walls. But anyway, yeah. Right now I'm doing the porches, and I think after this, I was meant to add the roof, but it wouldn't let me add it on the second story because there was nothing there. And then same with stairs, like I hadn't risen up the foundation yet because there was no walls, so I couldn't. I had to do this weird thing and make the porches rooms again because it wouldn't let me raise up the porches. So I did have to skew the order a little bit just for technological reasons. So instead of going paint, porch, roof, stairs, walls, windows, I've gone ahead and gone walls. I went porch, walls, paint, stairs, roof, windows. I think that's what I did. So I did have to skew the order a little bit. Yeah, here you can see me adding the roof, whereas I just couldn't do that before because it wouldn't let me. So sorry, that might like technically be cheating a little bit, but it's the only way I could make it work. But yeah, one of the final things I'm going to be doing is adding windows, which pained me because it's usually one of the first things I do. And you'll notice, especially in the bathroom, there's only one space where I can place a window. And even then, it's still in a weird place where I wouldn't usually place it. Same with the kitchen. Like, there's no windows in the kitchen except for, like, on the outskirts of it. The bedroom's windows are kind of weird. The living room has, like, way too many windows, but I hadn't placed enough paintings because I didn't know where the windows were going to go. It was a mess. And yeah, I did at this point sort of realize I had deleted all of my flooring because I had to remake everything a room and whatnot, and it got rid of my flooring. So I just went ahead and added it in, but I didn't let myself change it at all. I tried not to anyway, because I didn't want to like cheat and change it afterwards. So now I'm going ahead and painting the walls. And I think after this, I add the windows, but oh my God, windows were like the worst thing ever. Because I just didn't leave myself enough room for windows because I really wanted to challenge myself to add lots of paintings and things on the walls because I wanted to make sure that the walls weren't blank. But then some spaces I didn't even leave enough room for windows and I had too many paintings. But then in this living room, there are no paintings and too many windows. So it's kind of like, but I tried to make up for it by adding a fireplace and a mounted TV. So it sort of takes up that strip of the wall. And also I decided to punish myself for forgetting the living room earlier. And I punished myself by forcing myself to use the round fish tank coffee table from My First Pet Stuff. So I hope that you can forgive me and that me having to use that fish tank coffee table is enough for you to forgive me. So yeah, I don't know. I tried a lot with this painting thing. I sort of decided like, okay, I'll just put some paintings up on this wall now. And like, I don't know. And I sort of felt like it was cheating because I was meant to put the paintings up before the walls technically. So it was like, but yeah, I did a little bit of a skew of painting over there. So it didn't look as bad, but yeah, now I'm sort of making this like entryway to the living area because the living room is huge. Once again, when you don't do floor plan first, it's kind of hard to gauge where to put the furniture and how long to make the house, like where to put the porch when you haven't designed the living room yet. So we also had this little living area that's kind of segregated by a bookshelf and stuff. And it's basically just a little reading entryway study nook. Like, I don't know. But then like, if I was saying that a single female lived in this house, why does she have such a big living space? Like, this living space is fit for a whole entire family. So maybe we're going to go ahead and pretend that she has a partner and maybe she has guests over frequently, or I don't know, maybe she is expecting a child and they're gonna build on a bedroom at some point. I don't know, because it is just huge. And we got this like cramped little dining table up near the kitchen and then this big huge living area. And it's like, why did I do that? All right, because I had to do this in alphabetical order instead of like logical order. But as much as I'm bagging on it, I did have a lot of fun doing this challenge. But I think it was about 1 minute real time. I just got so sick of it. I'd been doing this for ages and it was getting kind of late at night. I was getting kind of cranky and I was just like, I'm so mad at myself because look at this, look at that house. Oh, it's so ugly. It's actually not that bad, but it's just not how I envisioned it. And if I didn't have to do it with ABC rules, I could have just made this look so much better. So I think I'm gonna have to go ahead and make a similar house to this again in the future. Also, the only thing that really turned out kind of weird was there's this wall along the porch on the right side. There's just like one tile of wall where I should have done fencing, but I did a wall for some reason. So that's there. But I noticed there was like this weird spot where there was no windows and the windows look kind of weird with the roof line, but that's the only place I could put them. So I went ahead and put some like creeping plants up and it looks okay, but I don't know. I like the porches and that's about it. The bedroom's actually nice as well, but here we are in the screenshots. If you want to download this, it is on the gallery. And surprisingly, A few people have downloaded this lot, which makes me question why, because I don't really like it that much personally. But if you do like this house, or if you want to go ahead and, you know, renovate it a little bit to look a little bit better here, there, everywhere, go ahead and feel free to do so. Once again, I didn't playtest it because at that point I was sort of sick of seeing the house. So if some things might be broken, feel free to fix them and let me know. But yeah, if you try this challenge, make sure to share it with the hashtag ABC Challenge. Please check out the videos linked in the description. And yeah, send me some photos if you try this. I want to see if anyone else can do a really good job, or if you fail just like me. Who knows? But until next time, I hope you'll have a very snazzy day, and I'll see you all soon. Bye, guys!